Hi, I'm Chris and I make knives. In today's video, we're heat treating blade steel. Welcome to my workbench. These six blades go with the six falling star I'm bringing to the blade show. What I'm about to do now is I'm going to heat treat these blades. This steel that I use is Carpenter's XHP. It is a stainless tool steel. And before you heat treat them, they are more susceptible to rust. To prevent that, I coat the blades in WD-40. So the first thing I need to do is I'm going to clean these blades in the ultrasonic cleaner, followed by a wipe down with acetone. Just some quick tips. When you're storing your blades, it's best if you can store them without stacking them on top of each other. That's bad. You want to keep the blades separate. Ideally, you would have them in some container where nothing's touching. So I've cleaned my blades, and now I need to make my pouches. This is 309 heat treating foil. Some people call it tool wrap. It's 20 thousandths thick. It's good up to 2000 degrees Fahrenheit. And what we're going to do now is we're going to make some little pouches to put the blades in. So what I've done is I pulled 9 inches off the roll, I cut that, and then I cut those into 8-inch pieces. So I have a square here it's not square, it's 9 inches by 8. What I'm going to do now is I'm going to put the blade in the center of this and then fold it onto itself. Make a nice little pouch. You're going to be real careful when you're handling with this foil. The edges of it's very sharp, it can cut you just like a knife. I did double crimp these edges. So I told you this foil was sharp. I don't know where or how it got me, but I'm starting to see blood on my foil and on my hands and stuff on my tooling plate. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go wash my hands real quick, find a cut, put a Band-Aid on it. What we're going to do next is I'm going to put argon gas in this foil. I double crimped the edges. And now what I'm going to do is I'm going to go put argon gas inside my little pouch. The specific weight of argon is 1.38. It's heavier than air. So when you put the argon gas in there, treat it like a glass of water. Don't spill it any. And then reseal it quickly and you'll have an inert atmosphere inside this foil pouch. So once you pour that in there, you want to treat it like water. So here's my five blades. You say, well, Chris, you started with six. Where is it? That's a great question. I don't know. I dropped it in the floor. It totally disappeared. I've been looking for it for the last hour. If I find it, I'm going to heat treat it. But I really can't afford to spend a whole lot of time looking for it. It's a great mystery to me. You drop something in the floor, it disappears. Where does it go? I don't know. What I have here, these are just old blade steel that I have surface ground down to the exact thickness of my knife. What I'm using is called a plate quench. And this is just an inch thick 6061 aluminum plates. Very simply, take the blade steel out, put it down, and then put the quench plinch on top of it. And my spacers will prevent it from rocking. You can see that the kiln is crazy hot. It's 1875. So you want to wear some PPE. Welding gloves would probably be better. Get you a pair of channel locks, tongs, something like that. If you need more time, just push the add time button. Voila, you just added 5 minutes. I'm gonna start taking these out now. Be very careful when you set them down at this time. It's very easy to bow the tip of your blade. And these quench plates prevent the blade from bowing. So I'll watch my temperature here come back up to 1875 before I pull out the next blade. Lost one of my standoffs. This is now cool to where you can handle it. You see okay? Am I blocking the view? So we're going to cut these open and see how we did. And just so you know, I did find my sixth blade, and I heat treated that too. Be careful this foil don't cut you. A little bit of carbonization where we didn't have enough argon. So now what we're going to do is we're going to go to the surface plate and check to make sure it's flat. Welcome to the surface plate. We're now going to check the blade to make sure that it's flat. And it's flat. Take a filler gauge. Try to push underneath there. Filler gauge won't go. So this blade is flat. The next thing we're going to do is we're going to temper it. We're going to temper it at a lower temperature. Try to put them in the middle. When you're doing your tempering, you don't need the foil. So we're coming up on the end of the first temper. What I'm going to do now is I'm going to pull these out and let them air cool to room temperature. That'll take about 15 minutes. And then we're going to put them back inside the kiln. And again, take them to 400 degrees Fahrenheit, hold that for 1 hour. Some guys do a cryogenics between the two tempers. I don't do that. I'm able to get 62 on the Rockwell Hardness C with what I have in-house without having to deal with dry ice or liquid nitrogen. Any of that nasty stuff. That's one of the reasons why I really like Carpenter's XHP. It's been 20 minutes. These have now cooled down to room temperature. We'll put them back inside the kiln. And watch out for the kiln. It's still hot. And now what I'm going to do is test the Rockwell Hardness C to see where I'm at. And I want to test it up here near the stop pin so that it doesn't interfere with the track of my detent ball. Let's see if you guys can see. I'll try to hold the camera still. And it looks like I've got almost 62. It looks like 61 and a half. And I do have calibration plates. So I'm happy with that. And if you guys see this little divot right here near my thumb, near the stop pin, that's from the hardness test. Some guys will do three and take an average of all three. I just do one. And so what I'm going to do now is I'm going to remove all this scale by bead blasting it off there. And I'm also going to lap the pivot to remove any scale that might have fell inside the pivot hole. Welcome to my drill press. This is a barrel lap. It's just a 1/4 inch barrel lap. And what I'm going to do now is I'm going to use this diamond lapping paste and lap the inside of my pivot hole. Sometimes after the heat treat, scale builds up inside the pivot hole, and this is how I'm going to remove it. Using the drill press. This is just a stud to prevent the blades from pinwheeling. Something that I threaded and tapped to help protect my fingers. I hope you can hear me okay. I'm actually machining some pocket clips and I'll show you that in a future video. So what I have here, this is my blade and this is my pivot. And right now the pivot will not go into the blade. And what's happening is after heat treat, scale has built up inside this pivot hole. And so I'm gonna remove it using this barrel lap. So you wanna set this up so that, first of all, you have to know that you have no run out. Yeah, you gotta know your total run out for your barrel lap. Because if you're not careful at this time, you could hurt the knife. You want this to be completely 90 degrees to your spindle, and you don't want any run out at all on your drill press. So be sure, a lot of drill presses will have run out. You want to be sure to check that to make sure that it's accurate. Choose your drill press very carefully. It's a class Z accuracy. It's accurate within 2/10,000ths of an inch. A quarter inch will not go, and the 249 1,000 smaller is too small. And so what I've been doing is I've just been press fitting to get a feel when I do the barrel lap. I actually used a pivot, and this is kind of what I'm looking for. So my question to you guys, if there's anyone out there that can answer this, is how do you accurately measure your holes in a small shop to the 10,000ths of an inch? This is a Z-set pin gauge, which I think is accurate to within, and so that's only accurate to within 2/10,000ths of an inch. I'd like to be able to measure this beyond just, you know, fitting. So if anybody could answer to me how I can accurately measure that without, like, you know, a TMM machine or a laser or something crazy expensive, I'd like to know if you can answer that question for me. We're going to bead blast the blade. Just so you guys can see what I've done, I used a blast cabinet to remove the scale from the knife. And it's a great way to get down inside all your jimping, especially the tiny jimping and the engraving. So I've removed all the scale from the knife, and I've also lapped a pivot. This knife is ready for the next process. I think I'm going to grind a lock on the back of the blade. And I'm going to show you guys that in a future video. Please subscribe, stay tuned, and thanks for watching.